is what was an amazing offensive display from this guy in the first half. Where did that scoring explosion come from?
I don't really know. To be honest, I was just looking for a chance to get my shot off. And I just happened to find him over and over in that first half. So.
And the third quarter about ready to get underway. You look at Freak in this game, he has been everywhere.
How about a double-double already? I mean, this is the sort of energy performance that just energizes your entire team.
He has impacted the game in a bunch of different ways. Really going to be hard to slow him down now. I tell you what, this has been fun to watch.
And Charlotte looking at who they've got. Kemba Walker is out there with Roberson. Then there's Al Jefferson. Then it's Amir Johnson, and it's Kidd Gilchrist in at the three spot.
Not only is their lead big, but their advantage on the boards is huge, too.
They've been the aggressors, plain and simple, outworking them, fighting for every loose ball. Nice move and finish. I think the halftime break really gave him a second win.
And Walker kicks to Kidd Gilchrist. Jefferson down low. Lopez is there. Jefferson's shot is off.
They really depend on him to convert those chances. A lot of times, even with solid D draped on him, they expect him to make it.
Outside Jack, a three ball, and he gets it to go. Jack's got 9 points.
That makes three in a row to start the second half.
Jack against Walker. They get it, and he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down. He's got 8. Nets leading by 13, and Jack picks to Barbosa. It's Evans, top of the key, and down it goes, jamming that one home.
But we're seeing the shots start to fall for them now.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, this has been an extremely efficient second half for them up to this point.
Screen by Jefferson. Now here's Kidd Gilchrist. Tight defense on him. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2.
And now let's take a moment to check out the stats for Walker. He's been in good form here the last few weeks. He's around 18 points per game, 7 assists, and 2 rebounds. They're loving how he's running the show here. His sensational passing really breathing life into their offense.
You know, the scheme just seems to run much more smoothly when he's in the game because he knows where everybody is at all times.
Outside Jack. Evans kicks to Jack. Here's the screen. He feeds it to Lopez. Fires from 14. Another one falls for Brooklyn.
Scoring well here at the midway point, and now they're starting to put some distance between.
Well, offensively, they just continue to roll. I mean, they're padding that lead bit by bit as a result.
All right now. Doris Burton has some information for us. Doris?
Yes, Kevin. I had a chance to find out what Charlotte's coach was going over with his guys. He's looking for some old-fashioned offense right now. He wants the pick and roll to be the centerpiece of their game plan at that end of the floor. He also wants them to concentrate on working as a team at the offensive end. Passing, patience, and teamwork, those were the messages. Coach was not wasting any time in altering their strategy here in the second half. And Kevin, he's going to have to hope those changes take effect quickly.
And thank you, Doris. Evan's shot is good.
Really not hard to see why they're giving up points on this run. I mean, they've just given them too many looks inside.
Yeah, and usually when a team goes on a run like this, it's because they are getting too many opportunities on the inside. Make them beat you from deep.
Deflects the pass. Kidd Gilchrist with the steal. Lets it go from 11, and that's good for 2. Kidd Gilchrist has got his second bucket of the night. And here are the Nets. They're on a 13-5 run. Jack passes to Evans. Back to Jack. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. Evans inside. He's guarded by Johnson. And it's Evans missing. And Walker kicks to Jefferson. Robertson can't hit. Nets leading by 16. Jack dishes to Evans. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there. And guys, what do you think about the offensive approach we've seen so far for the Nets?
And when they've worked the ball into the post throughout this game, they have had success.
They've also been pounding it inside tonight and coming away with a lot of points in the paint. I call those PIPs.
Bargnani is checked in for Brooklyn. And Walker kicks to Kidd Gilchrist. Jefferson setting the pick for Kidd Gilchrist. Pass to Jefferson. Puts up the baby hook. It's in and good for his sixth field goal in 10 attempts. The Nets have gotten six of their seven shots to go down in this quarter. What a fantastic start to the half. Pass to Hollis Jefferson. He kicks it to Jack. Now the feed to Evans. And fouled as he went up to the dunk. Good aggressive move, and he'll shoot two. This will be his fifth trip to the free throw line.
That's his second.
That's good from Evans.
Shooting for Brooklyn. Three. Two shots.
And both free throws good for Evans. Hornets trail by 18. And Walker kicks to Roberson. Jefferson against Bargnani. Jefferson missing again.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
Evans passes to Bargnani. Evans against Johnson. Now the pass to Hollis Jefferson. Just five on the clock. Goes up at the stripe. No good from Bargnani. The Hornets have gone 3 of 8 so far in the third quarter, looking to lock in that rhythm. The dish now to Robertson. Johnson the screen. Shoots off the screen. Cannot hit. So Brooklyn will take it the other way. Last time they met was in Charlotte, where they beat the Hornets.
Yeah, a dominant win for them their last time in this matchup. And what jumps off the stat page was their advantage on the boards.
Yeah, they were overpowering it inside. And you've really got to like their chances, Greg, if they can replicate that tonight.
Jefferson, that's good.
Boy, just an excellent assist. Nice work from Kemba Walker.
Nets leading by 16. And here is Jack. 9 points in the game so far. Kicks it to Evans. Pass to Hollis Jefferson. Evans against Johnson. Evans right side. And he gets it to go. Evans has got 42 in the game.
And they're really in a good position here, thanks in part to the way he's been able to score the basketball.
Walker goes in. Johnson, the shot's good on the assist by Walker. 6 points for Johnson.
Boy, such outstanding patience and decision-making for them offensively.
Absolutely. Their ball movement has been outstanding, and they're piling up the assists.
Pick by Bargnani. Evans dishes to Bargnani. Evans left side. They set the pick. To the paint. Deflects the pass. Kidd Gilchrist with the steal. And a fast break now for the Hornets. Here's Roberson. He's got five. And Kidd Gilchrist kicks to Jefferson. And it's Walker penetrating. Outside Kidd Gilchrist. The Hornets need to get a shot off here. Walker's shot is off. Nets leading by 16. Here's Barbosa. They get a hand on it. Here's Roberson. He dishes it to Walker. At the elbow, Jefferson. No problems knocking that one down. Jefferson's got 17 now.
He has such a nice touch for a big man.
Yeah, and they've got to figure out a way to get a bigger body on him, because if they don't match up his size, then he's going to continue to work them over the rest
of the game.
Well, a lot of tough teams in this league. Here's where Brooklyn sits right now. First in scoring, in assists, and they're also number one in shooting percentage. This is a team that prides itself on taking high-quality shots.
And you go back to their offense, the most explosive in the league. I mean, everyone talks about the great offense beating great defenses, and I tell you what, they make it difficult to hang with them.
Well, the effort was there, but he just couldn't quite fight his way through traffic.
Here's Batum, and there's a nice one-handed slam.
Easy to see who's going to win that race.
Yeah, early offense is often easy offense. Excellent work that time.
Galloway gets a screen from Evans. Good on the shot. Evans has got 44.
Wow, unconscious has he been this quarter. They're riding that hot hand.
Zeller, a screen on Thornton. Outside, Lynn. Zeller setting the pick for Lynn. Brooklyn with the rebound. They come into this one having outplayed the Magic last game.
The thing I took away from that game was just how dominant they were on the backboard.
Well, it would have been hard not to see how dominant they were based on the numbers. I mean, they just completely dominated the glass.
Brooklyn leading by 12. Here's Galloway. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Fades away, and he gets the bucket.
And bullseye with that assist. Nice delivery there in traffic.
Charlotte's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Outside, Batum. Back to Lynn. Brooklyn with the rebound. Evans has got his 20th rebound here tonight. Saw that coming. Young with the ball. And Batum picks him up defensively. Fades away. And again, another basket there from Evans. Evans has got 48.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
There's a good screen. Outside, Walker. Unloads from 13. Walker missing again.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Picked by Bargnani. Evans outside. Young outside. Here's Galloway. And again, Brooklyn with the triple.
And they've got to talk to each other on D there. Miscommunication, and now he's able to make a pay.
Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cottonmouth here. Dry spell for sure.
And it's Walker penetrating. There's the bucket. Good. Walker's got 6 points in the quarter.
You can see that they're not as aggressive from the three-point arc. They had far more attempts in the first half.
Galloway, the pass to Evans. Zeller grabs the board.
That's what we call good defense in the paint. Worth its weight in gold.
It absolutely is, and maybe even more than that. I mean, you saw it right there. Without his presence, that's an easy basket.
In transition, here come the Nets. Out of bounds. Charlotte takes possession. Brooklyn making some changes. Lopez, he's... 23 seconds left to play in the third. Now Lynn, 11 points in the game. Pick by Zeller. Lynn dishes to Lamb. Puts up a three. Can't get it to fall. And as we end the third quarter, a double-digit deficit will make it tough to come back. Nets lead by 17. 2K's. And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. Hornets trail by 17. A moment now to reset the lineups, brought to us by Gatorade. All fueled up here for the fourth quarter. So for Brooklyn now, Evans in at power forward. Jerjack is out there with Barbosa. And it's Young, and it's Lopez in at the five spot. Brooklyn leading by 15. Inside. Here's Evans. Here's Jack. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
Check out the game for Jack. 9 points and his huge assist tally makes it all the more impressive.
You know what? He's the catalyst. He's the reason why this team plays with such harmony. And if his passing continues, they are going to be dangerous.
Can you believe the job they're doing at the foul line since halftime? I mean, they've been perfect so far.
Yeah, as cool as can be, Clark. Great focus and efficiency. That's how they built this lead.
Lopez a screen. Evans kicks to Lopez. Hops loose off the pick and hammers it home.
Oh, Maestro, he is so good at making those lead passes, like conducting an orchestra.
Jefferson a screen on Jack. Here's Lynn. And the rejection by Evans. And now running up the court, Barbosa pushing it up. Kid Gilchrist with the steal. Feeds to Johnson. Gets a very good look and converts.
Textbook. Nice pass. Great catch. Even better finish.
Brooklyn leading by 17. We're just over a minute and a half now into the fourth. Young with no one around. The basket good off the assist from Evans. Evans has got 6 assists here tonight. Hornets have gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Lynn the pass to Jefferson. And the rejection by Evans. And it's Kid Gilchrist penetrating. 6 on the shot clock. Johnson the screen. High arcing shot. And it's going to be a 24-second shot clock violation. They turn it over. And the Nets making a change here. Hollis Jefferson's checked in. Walker's checked in for Charlotte. Evans outside. Down low. And it's thrown down hard with both hands.
Well, I tell you, he squeezed that orange as tight as he could before that throwdown.
Yeah, no way he was going to lose that thing on the way up. You're right, Clark.
And better safe than sorry on that one, guys.
Take a look at what Kemba Walker's done. He has 12 points and 7 assists.
And if I had to pick what he's done best today, I'd probably lean towards the offensive performance.
Well, just to be a contrarian, I'm going to go to the other side because he's been just as impressive, I think, at the defensive end.
And over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. Lopez, a screen on Johnson. Out to the right wing. Hollis Jefferson passes to Evans. He's looking for Lopez and finds him. That one goes. Count. Lopez has got 4 this quarter.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
You know, the defense, Greg, has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. 4 straight field goals have been made off an assist.
Barbosa dishes to Evans. It's stolen by Johnson. Outside, Walker. And Roberson kicks to Jefferson. Can't get it to go. So Brooklyn will take it the other way. Jack passes to Lopez. Kid Gilchrist with the steal. Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by. Jack against Walker. Dishes to Roberson. Johnson the screen. Just 5 to shoot. And Kid Gilchrist gets it to go in.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play.
Jack dishes to Lopez. And a great assist by Jack as that one goes in. Jack's got 6 assists now in the game. Hornets trail by 21. Outside, Walker. Out to the right wing. Roberson misses the 3. Brooklyn's gone 3-7 tonight from 3-point territory. And the dunk by Evans.
Kevin, I tell you what, when he gets to the rim like that, he's really hard to stop.
Yeah, he can get up a few notches higher, there's no doubt.
And that's how the game is played on the inside. You can play over the top. You've got a great advantage.
Michael shot's good.
Uh-oh, a little showboating at the end of that one.
Nets leading by 21. Left side, Jack. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. Lopez sets a screen for Evans. And it's Lopez at the elbow. Excellent D there by Johnson.
You can see how much the defense respects him. I mean, they were all over him on that look.
And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
That's his second personal foul. Shooting.
That's good from Kemba Walker.
Kemba Walker. Taking two shots.
He makes one of two that time.
Of course, he didn't have an attempt there in the first half. He's hoping to be a little bit more active and aggressive here and draw some fouls here in the second.
Evans with it. There's a good screen. Pass to Hollis Jefferson. Four on the clock. Got a piece of it. Kid Gilchrist with the steal. And now running up the court. Kid Gilchrist pushing it up. Charlotte again missing. The Nets have gotten it done so far from the field here in the fourth. Going 6-for-7. And a fast break now for the Hornets. Kid Gilchrist leading the charge. And Roberson kicks to Walker. 14 feet away. And there's Al Jefferson on the assist by Walker. And that's now 21 points for Al Jefferson. Nets leading by 18. Jack passes to Evans. Here's Hollis Jefferson. He's guarded by Johnson. Stolen by Walker. And here's the fast break. Left side Jefferson from 12 feet out. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in. Jefferson's got 23.
No doubt about it. He has done a ton to help his team, but he's going to have to do even more if they want to have a chance to get back in this.
Pass to Hollis Jefferson. Back to Evans. Six on the shot clock. It's stolen by Jefferson. Outside, Kid Gilchrist. And it's Walker penetrating. Lopez with the block. Now here is Barbosa. Stolen by Walker. Johnson the screen. Here's the floater. Walker's shot is off.
And the shots just continue to say no in terms of falling.
It's stolen by Jefferson. Walker against Barbosa. And Kid Gilchrist kicks to Jefferson. Knocked away. It's stolen by Jefferson. And he gets it to go.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Evans against Johnson. Tries to snap the cold streak. It's rebounded by Kid Gilchrist. Kid Gilchrist has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. He feeds it to Roberson. The three-pointer, no good.
You know what? He's just stone cold right now. Really not sure if he's their best option offensively as they try to get back in this game.
Johnson against Evans to the middle. Here's Lopez. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
They've had trouble the way Lopez has been playing. He's got 14 points and two steals. He's showing us those quick hands today, both when he has the ball and when he doesn't.
Clark, you love the fact that he's a terrific distributor, but also, how about those defensive instincts? That's also been excellent today.
And it's Walker penetrating. Here's Johnson. Lopez with the block. It's Evans on the wing to the middle. Barbosa dishes to Lopez. And play stops. as it looks like they call an over-the-back here.
Yeah, no doubt about that one with the over-the-back call.
Yeah, it looked like he wanted to take him for a ride right there. Easy call.
Johnson the screen. Here's Walker. Again, the miss by Walker.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
Got it. Let's get the ball inside.
Evans passes to Jack. Evans against Jefferson. And it's Lopez. One time on the assist by Evans. Evans has got 9 assists in the game. Great passing. Hornets trail by 18. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
All right now.
Outside, Walker. He kicks it to Jefferson.
That's a war.
The shot is off. Evans with some nice deep. Brooklyn leading by 18. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. And Jack kicks to Evans. Lopez up top, back to Evans. Down to 5 on the shot clock. The kick out to Lopez. Jack with the 3. And again, Brooklyn with the triple.
The three-point shot has been a real weapon for them in the second half.
Yeah, they've really done a good job of creating good looks from the outside. And now they've really got it going.
2 minutes to go in the game. 2.
Walker goes in. And the rejection by Evans. Jack's shot is good.
And it's all one-way traffic tonight, boy. They have been lights out offensively.
And there's no telling how big that lead's going to get. But, again, it's just one game, but nonetheless a very impressive one the way they've handled their business here.
Jefferson kicks to Roberson. Johnson the screen. Jefferson has a wide-open look. Jefferson missing again. Brooklyn with the ball. 9 points in a row. Good run for him right now.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for the Nets.
But, Steve, you know, you don't see this kind of a blowout often. But tonight, this is a quality win across the board to deliver out, Clark, this kind of punishment to
him. Well, you know what? I thought they did a nice job of playing against the game. They kept the pressure on. And clearly, we're dominant in every area.
And so looking at their number, this will be win number 22 on the year.
With a solid strategy, building on that first win in this season series, they rack up another W to make it 2-0. And with 1 left to play this year against the Hornets.
And you have to look back at this and see the huge game it was for Evans. He came out and let everyone know that points would be hard to come by with the way he swatted away shots and protected the rim.
And taken away by Johnson. 1 second separate in the shot clock and game clock. Jefferson dishes to Roberson. And a wide open look for Walker. Busts the J after the cagey pass fake. There's 14 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Barbosa kicks to Evans. Lopez a screen. Evans outside. Off the screen. No good. And so it's Brooklyn easily grabbing this one. And the outcome of this one was never in doubt.
Yeah, they were clicking in every way. I mean, all cylinders go. No question about that. And once they pulled away, they didn't let up.
And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Once again, you find yourself with a points and rebounds double-double. Is that something you've come to expect from yourself on a nightly basis?
I don't know that reaching certain benchmarks like a double-double means much, but I always expected myself to come out and battle for rebound.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Thank you, Kevin, and now let's move on to the presentation of Freak. It was nothing short of a professional offensive. And, folks, that's it for us. Thank you for tuning in. Always a pleasure. For Kenny the Jets.
episode of NBA 2K TV, we show you some never-before-seen footage from this season. Of course, you can earn some VC with 2K TV Interact.
You guys want to get a little tighter?
Okay.
Act like we like each other, I guess.
What's up, guys? I'm Rachel, and welcome to our Thanksgiving special episode of NBA 2K TV. On this week's episode, you vote on who wins 10,000 VC for the top play of November. We show you some never-before-seen clips from the season and show off your 2K TV thanks submissions. So let's jump into it.
There's a long hallway at Oracle Arena, right where I shoot the tunnel shot back to our locker room. And after I make the tunnel shot, I do like a full sprint down the hallway past like all the ushers, all the fans and all that. I don't know why, I'm just kind of weird like that.
It's like cats.
Like what?
Like cats. You know when cats have that burst of energy?
Yes, that's it. That's it. That's it. I had to catch up with you, but now I know what you mean.
The inventions.
Yeah, I got a lot of Shaq accessories. One of my dreams one day is to start a company called Shaq Accessories, but my dreams are cute, but I'm still kind of nervous. I'm putting them out. Like, I got one for kids, Shaq shoe piggy bank. It'd be an actual shoe. Got a lot of stuff. I don't want to tell you everything, but.
I like the Shaq accessories,
yes,
though.
It's coming soon.
That's really cool.
Thank you.
Jimmy Buffett with the Miami Heat. He got, I see, he, you know what? I've never been thrown out of a game. He was thrown out of a game.
Is that on your bucket list to get thrown out of a game?
No, never. That's never going to happen.
Okay.
Not in Madison Garden, at least. On the road, maybe.
Maybe
but
in
not
LA.
The Garden.
There's a lot of funny moments, but when someone does something wrong and Spike goes, whoa, whoa, and he comes running out of there and his hat's crooked and he'll be like, ah, what are you doing? I go off script a lot.
So let's talk about your playlist a little bit. How long did it take you to kind of choose those songs and then go ahead and make the original mixes?
It didn't take long at all because I got right in the studio, started cooking up, and put my playlist together. And I knew I would want to hear while I'm playing the game anyways. And I feel like I represent the people out there, and I make music that we all can relate to, and I feel like the records I picked is some of the classics. It's a vibe. It's a vibe.
Do you have a favorite?
Yeah, I think I'm excited that All I Do Is Win is in there. You know, there's a lot of, all of them my favorite, but just that record, it represents the winners, and I feel like it inspires everybody that's playing the game to win. You know, that's the goal. Is right. Imagine playing and the record comes on, All I Do Is, you know what I'm saying? You know, you're a winner.
Nobody wants to lose
exactly.
In 2K.
You notice I didn't even say that word. What's that word?
Oh wait, no, I can't say it either because I don't want an L word either.
Yeah, I don't say that word.
My senior year, that's when everybody started talking about me and I became number one in the country in high school, and I was like, oh, I'm actually okay now. And so that's when I thought, like, all right, let me pursue this basketball thing hard. And that's when I started working harder, watching film, you know, watching old games, watching the NBA more. And that's when I thought, like, all right, I can make a career out of this.
So your senior year, you kind of like flipped that switch. You're like, let's really take this seriously now.
Yeah.
So I heard you talk about like a lot of conditioning. Use that on the track and running sprints.
Too much.
So what was the worst conditioning moment that you had at this high school?
I think just having to do ladders. Ladders is when we get in the gym and we run, you know, four sprints up to like 22 times. You know.
Four full court back and forth?
Yep. And so you're just thinking about that all day. You know, in the morning, coach tell you got to run ladders, you know, for six period. You're thinking about that all day. And so when you finally get to it, you know, it's pretty painful, but after you feel good.
Did you throw up at all ever
no,
in a trash
but
can?
I slowed down a little bit.
When did you start becoming a LeBron fan?
Actually, I was more of a LeBron fan. People say, like, I'm like a front runner and everything.
Bandwagon?
Yeah.
I get that too,
don't worry. But there's a picture of me when I was two wearing a LeBron jersey, and I need to show that to all my friends so they get a taste.
2 years old, so what year was that?
2006. People say I'm like a bandwagoner and everything. Nope, I'm a LeBron fan from two. Yes, you got it. LeBron, I got you. I'm a true Cavalier and LeBron fan.
I like it. LeBron, if you're listening.
Yes.
Miles Brown right here is your new skills coach.
Yes.
You got to meet him sooner or later.
Yes, we got to play pickup or something like that.
I'm thankful for all of you guys who watch the show every single week and for those of you who interact with us. And I'm also thankful for the opportunity to be able to interview some of the best athletes in the world and, of course, share those experiences with you guys. And I'm also thankful for cats. Can't forget about the cats.
I'm thankful for my family, thankful for this amazing community, and of course, Blacktop Mode.
I'm thankful that nobody made too big a fun of my last appearance that I'm aware of.
For my family, for my health, for getting to do something that I love every day, and for Kobe's 20th season.
Having the opportunity to work on NBA 2K.
Andre Drummond, of course, signed jersey over there. My family for being extremely supportive even during the summer. Oh, and I should say my girlfriend for not breaking up with me during the summer.
For street taco stands and thousand count thread sheets.
I'm thankful for being part of the NBA 2K team.
I'm thankful for most of my family. That's terrible.
I'm thankful for my wonderful girlfriend, Danielle.
I'm thankful for everybody here at 2K TV. I'm thankful to this guy right here, my right-hand man, Mr. Mike Wang.
Thanks, brother.
My unsigned Paul George jersey? Can I get a picture of him holding up the photo of me? Is that weird? I would be thankful for that. I would be so thankful for that.
Here, 2K Games recently partnered with Make-A-Wish Foundation to bring an NBA 2K superfan's wish come true. His day included a visit to our 2K TV studios and finished with a trip to the Warriors Oracle Arena. All of us at 2K were happy to make it happen. You can help make more kids' dreams a reality at wish.org.
Happy Thanksgiving to all.
If you guys haven't jumped into my team yet, I think that the holidays would be the perfect time to start. And I want to see your best lineup, so make sure that you submit those on social media using the hashtag 2KTVBestMT for a chance to be featured in an upcoming episode.
So what up, 2K fans? It's your boy Shake, aka Mr. Top 10. You know who it is. This week, you guys are voting for the 2KTV Top Play of the Month, where the winner will receive 10,000 VC. First up, we have our defending champion, Jay Gary 2, with his infamous alley-oop between the legs over the defender's head. Then we have Wright's boy, with his no-look over-the-shoulder lob catching and flying over defenders. Welcome to my poster. Then we have The Fame Is Real, with the 360 between the legs spinning around the defender. Good defense, but much better offense. Then we have the Almighty Dom, with this amazing putback windmill slam. Only in a pair of Jordans do you get hang time like that. So vote now for the second 2KTV Top Play of the Month, where the winner will receive 10,000 VC. It's your boy Shake. I'll holla at you dudes later.
Thank you guys for watching. Have an amazing holiday, and I'll see you soon. And show off your 2K TV thanks submissions. Tune in now.
You notice I didn't even say that word. What's that word?
Hey guys, on today's episode of NBA 2K TV, we show you some never-before-seen footage from this season. Of course, you can earn some VC with 2K TV Internet.